Yes. You're reading the fucking title correctly. Banks controlling gun sales. Yeah, that's not fucking deeply disturbing. That's not something that I find absolutely abhorrent and fucking horrifying. That's just... What the fuck? Why did you think that was a good fucking idea? On any goddamn level. We aren't even past the title yet, and I'm already going, what the fuck? But let's get into this. Let's get into this fucking goddamn stupidity. Okay. This opening bit here is goddamn insane. Okay. For the past year, chief executives have often talked about the new sense of moral responsibility that corporations have to help their communities and confront social challenges, even when Washington won't. Okay. There's a problem with that. Corporations don't have moral responsibilities. I would like them to not be an asshole and to not do things that are illegal. But you know what? They can be as immoral and unethical as they want, as long as it's fucking legal. Because corporations exist to do one thing. Make goddamn money. That's it. Let's just be fucking honest about that. That's why they exist. They're not going to be nice to you. Google's not going to be fucking nice to you. All of these banks aren't going to be nice to you. They don't give a fuck about you. You are a walking dollar sign to them. So let's stop pretending and just be honest about what they are and treat them accordingly. They're not, you know, the friendly mom and pop stores that used to exist. Those actually are acting like that. Do you want to know why? Because they're owned by a private citizen and the private citizen's going, well, you know what? I'm doing pretty well. I'll help out my community. Okay, that's why. Because they're local. It's a tiny local thing. They need the area around them to not suck. Otherwise, their business gets kicked in the dick. It's enlightened self-interest. Giant corporations don't need to do that because they're over fucking half the damn planet. Doesn't fucking matter to them. So they don't have a moral responsibility. I wish they would act like it, but they don't. They use it here for PR spinning bullshit. That's all they do. You can't understand at this point. I do not like big corporations, and I want them to fucking be not super regulated, but to stop being treated like people. They're not people. Okay? Stop expecting them to act like people. Stop giving them the rights of people. You are a corporation. You are not a person. Okay? Now we've established that. And then they go on to babble about the fucking shooting in Florida because, oh my god, it's horrible. It is. Okay, I'm not trying to be fucking sarcastic on that one. But, oh my, can we shut up about it? Oh my god, he used an assault weapon. It's not a goddamn assault weapon. Okay? I understand that Bill Clinton called it a goddamn assault weapon. Because I actually checked this out. The general American definition of an assault weapon is something with a pistol grip and a detachable fucking magazine. Yes, that includes every single automatic pistol ever. And I don't mean fully automatic, I just mean the fucking, the slides, like a Glock. You know, a Glock, a Desert Eagle, an M1911, those all are considered goddamn assault weapons. I hope you can hear the air quotes in my fucking speech. It's insane. A goddamn shotgun. Okay, a shotgun, what is a shotgun? It's close range. You know what? You could call shotguns assault weapons if they have clips. That's kind of accurate. Here's the thing. We don't use shotguns for that anymore. I don't think we've actually issued shotguns. I don't even know if we still issue shotguns to our soldiers. I don't think we do. Frankly, an assault weapon is a military distinction. I don't think shotguns are military weapons anymore. And the AR-15 sure as fuck ain't. It's semi-automatic. And they're like, well, it's a semi-automatic clip fed or magazine fed with a pistol grip. So fucking what? Who gives a shit? It's a goddamn sporting rifle. It's semi-fucking automatic. What the hell are you babbling about? It's so dumb. It's so incredibly fucking stupid. It's not an assault weapon. Assault weapons are SMGs and assault rifles. Do you want to know those have in common? They're fully automatic. They generally have a select fire switch. The AR-15 does not. Here, I'm actually going to... I'm going to have some fun here. So I'm going to point this out here. I've got the M14. One of my personal favorite rifles. Okay. So let's take a look at this M14. Okay, here. Watch. Check this out. Here is a classic M14. This is actually a picture of an airsoft one, but it's accurate enough that we can tell. Now here's a modern one. Okay. Let's quack. This one. This one. What's the difference? Okay, besides that this one has a silencer or suppressor on it. Let's pretend that's not on there, because that's an optional attachment that you could probably stick on this bitch. Not actually, because it's an airsoft gun, but you know what I mean. Okay, so what does this have? A pistol grip, an extendable stock, and a rail system. All this rail system does is make it easy to take off this and put on different ones. You know, you just want, oh, you want to put on a reflex sight? Okay, fine. You want to go put on a holographic sight? Fine. You want to stick a flashlight under here? Fine. You want to stick a fucking bayonet attachment there? Fine. This gun can also have a fucking bayonet attachment. It goes right there. This gun can also have a scope, as is plainly visible in this goddamn picture. This gun could also have a modified stock. The difference is, this one is modifiable on the fly. Now, to be honest here, you're not going to modify it on the fly, because this bitch is firing 308 rounds, and you're not going to be fucking screwing around with that. You're going to have it set, and you're going to use it at that length. That is the same with this gun. You will either take parts off of the stock, or you will extend the stock. And you can do that. It's not fucking hard. The only actual functional fucking difference between this thing and this thing is that this fucking thing has a pistol grip. And I will be honest, that is a matter of comfort. That's it. It gives you, because you're now it's pushing back into your hand instead of your hand being at a slight angle. It gives you a better grip on fully automatic. But you know what? Neither of these is fucking fully auto. So it doesn't matter. If the gun's not fucking full auto, the pistol grip's just more comfortable. That's it. I can fucking, with a shotgun, okay, let's put it this way. Let's say I have a 22 version of these. Because I can fire that one-handed. I can fire both of those fucking one-handed. It doesn't matter if I have a pistol grip or not. Doesn't stop shit. The only difference between, and to continue these differences, that rail just makes it easier to take the fucking scope off. I can still take the goddamn scope off this bitch. It just takes a little longer. And you're not fucking swapping scopes in the middle of combat anyway. There's no functional fucking difference between the two of these things. One just looks new. That's fucking it. I would like to point out that this was a goddamn main battle rifle during the Korean War and into Vietnam. Okay? This is a military weapon. Was at one point. Okay? That's all this is. It's just the fancy military looking one. That's why everyone freaks out about the AR-15. It's not a goddamn military weapon. It's just a modern looking rifle. That's it. Here, I'm gonna fucking scare some people now. I spelled it right. I spelled that right. This is the Lee Enfield rifle. This was an honest-to-God military rifle. If I remember correctly, they used this in World War I. Guess what civilians were using at that point? Rifles very similar to this. Except in America, we use lever actions, but whatever. Lever actions were way more common than this, but that's not the point. Okay? These type of guns were common. It's very common for people to have what would be considered military-grade small arms. And that's all the AR-15 is. And I wouldn't even call it full-on military-grade, because it's not. It's not fucking fully automatic. That's it. You wouldn't see anyone in the military using this. It's just a very nice gun. Look at this thing. It has one rail. Is that a second rail there? Nope, it's got two rails. It's got a double rail system. That's all. Look at that. Whoopty shit. Okay, so I'm going to go do some long-range shooting today. So I'll go put my x4 scope on. You know, my big scope, my big zoom scope. Oh, I'm just going to do some, you know, some plinking. So I'll just put my little red dot on, and I'll just do some of that. That'll be fun. Oh, I want to have a bipod today, just because I want a bipod. Oh, I'm going to go coon hunting. That is raccoon hunting, for those of you who have dirty, dirty minds. Well, I'll just put a flashlight on my gun. So then I can make sure I'm shooting at what I think I'm shooting at. Now, you should also have a flashlight in your hand. I'm just pointing that out that you can, if you're going to shoot at the raccoon in the tree, it'd be rather nice to have the one on the barrel of your gun for when you're shooting at it. That's it. It's very nice. It's very convenient. Everyone freaking out about the fucking clips. Fuck, most of the clips they sell are only 10 rounds. They just look big. Because they, you know, firstly, a 10-round mag's fucking tiny. They're not that big. If you actually only had it be 10 rounds, it'd be like one of the little short box mags that sticks out of bolt actions. It'd be a pain in the ass to grab. So that's why, like, this could very easily be a 10-round magazine right here, depending on where you bought the gun. Because sometimes they can't sell 30-round mags. Or it could be a 20-round mag. Who gives a shit? Doesn't fucking matter. Okay? This gun is not a military weapon. Nor is it a goddamn assault weapon. Thank you, Bill Clinton, for fucking that one up. You may have done some halfway decent things in the 90s, but you have no knowledge of goddamn firearms, and you're a dumbass with your fucking assault weapons ban. Because most of what that affected was fucking shotguns. He's an idiot. But now, we're taking it out of the fucking conversation of our government. Now we're just gonna go let the banks rule it for us. Yeah, we're just gonna let the financial industry, you know, those people who fucked up several years ago and nearly went goddamn bankrupt with the housing crisis. Yeah, those, I'm sure they're just absolutely the most trustworthy, reliable people we could, you know, run this shit. Do you know what banks do? Banks do one thing. One thing only. They handle money. So if I want to transfer money to someone through the bank because I purchased a gun from them, they have to do it. Because that's how this fucking works. Okay? I'm a customer. I have broken no laws. I'm not doing anything illegal. You just have to suck it up and go with it. We shouldn't judge them for this. It's what they do. That's it. Oh, I just transferred money to money. Well, that guy used that money to buy drugs and killed himself. That's not my fucking problem. This guy wanted to send that guy $200, so we sent him $200. That's it. That's all they ever should do. Don't get their fucking noses out of politics. Get everything else. They shouldn't be involved. Ever. Keep the damn noses out and just do what the fuck they do. But it just keeps going. It's like, oh, we'll just let them fucking do it. No. No, are you goddamn insane? We are not opening this Pandora's box. Because then what? They just gonna shut down entire industries they don't like? Seriously, that's what they're gonna do. They're just gonna shut down entire industries they don't like. Fuck, already PayPal, Squire, Stripe, and Apple Pay that they do not allow their services to be used for the sale of firearms. Why? I don't even get it. I don't understand the logic. But here's the quote from Square. We do not believe permitting the sale of firearms on our platform is consistent with our values or in the best interest of our customers. So what? If I want to fucking sell some dude a hunting shotgun so he can go hunt fucking pheasants or ducks or something, that's not consistent with your values or in the best interest of your customers? What the fuck? That's retarded. It makes no fucking sense. I want to sell a guy a thing. He wants to buy the thing. You are nothing more than a money facilitator. Stop assigning morality to yourselves. Your job is for me to give you money, and then you give that money to the other guy. That's it. That's all you fucking do. You don't make any judgments about it. You don't do anything else. As long as it's not fucking illegal, you're supposed to do it. That's it. But no, it's got to be fucking moral. You got to sit there and virtue signal about how virtuous and wonderful we are. Well, fuck you. But fucking big financial firms don't even have to go that far. Oh, dear God. Like, where the fuck does this go? Visa, they published a 71-page paper. Jesus, fuck. In 2016, espousing its corporate responsibility. Really? Your corporate responsibility? No. You have one responsibility as a corporate entity. That is to make money for your shareholders. Okay? Now, I personally feel that should extend to make money for your shareholders, not fuck over your customers, and not fuck over your employees. I think there's three responsibilities there. But no, it's like they're already saying that they could easily change its terms of service, say that it won't do business with retailers that sell assault weapons, high-capacity magazines, and pump stocks, which make semi-automatic rifles fire faster. Even the National Rifle Association has said it would support tighter restrictions on pump stocks. The fucking NRA said, you know what? But, you know, this is going back to that Obama thing. I remember reading it. I don't know where the fuck I read it. But during the Obama administration, they're the ones that legalized pump stocks. And the NRA was kind of like, eh. They didn't say no because they're like, oh, hey, that's kind of neat, I guess. but they weren't pushing for it. Everyone after Vegas was going, look what the NRA wanted. The NRA's like, we never fucking wanted that. They it was there, and we're like, oh, okay. Because the NRA doesn't really want that. Because bump stocks are really fucking shitty for your gun. Because an AR-15 is not designed to shoot that fast. So if you shoot that fast, you'll melt your goddamn barrel. This is the point I'm getting at. Everyone who's against fucking guns thinks the NRA is Satan and wants everyone to run around with goddamn LMGs. I will be honest. Most of the NRA is like, no. We would like people to be able to purchase LMGs if they so choose, but we have no problem with saying, oh, if you want to purchase a gun of this size and fire rate or etc., that you should probably have to have some sort of certification. They don't have an issue with that. They're just saying, hey, hunt shotguns, handguns, hunting rifles, and probably AR-15s. No, everyone should be able to have access to those. That's just fair. Because it is. Second Amendment, bitches! That's how this fucking works! Okay, we have it written in. I have the right to bear arms. Fuck you, I do. It's like, Jesus Christ, it's no caveats on that. I have the right to bear arms. You're not allowed to take away my guns. You'd have to make a goddamn amendment to the Constitution to do that. And you're never going to get enough support for that. There are way too many states that are going to give you the giant bird on that one. Put right here. If MasterCard were to do the same, assault weapons would be eliminated from virtually every firearm store in America, because otherwise the sellers would be cut off from the credit card system. I have a very important thing to tell you. Most people, if they're going to be buying an AR-15 or whatever, generally don't get them from stores. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. Whatever. You know what? I would buy mine in cash. Oh my god, I could just buy my gun with cash. Or just go to a gun show where everyone expects you to fucking buy the gun in cash. Everyone just expects that. It's not new. This isn't weird. It's what most people already do. And you're just retarded. But then there we go. There's already precedent for credit card issuers to ban the purchase of completely legal products. Because JP Morgan Chase, Citigroup, and Bank of America banned the use of their cards to buy Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. Because they're terrified of what Bitcoin is going to do to them. That's it. And you want to know what's going to happen? If they do that, we'll just start doing it with Bitcoin, dumbass. Bitcoin is a really easy way to facilitate online transfers. Fuck you. I'll just buy my gun with Bitcoin. That's all you're going to fucking do, dumbasses. We're just going to walk around. Oh, I can't use my credit card to buy this gun. Well, I guess I can't buy that gun anymore. No, fuck, no one's going to do that. They're just going to go, oh, okay, I'll just get it next week. I'll go to the bank, pick up my $1,000, come back, I'll buy my gun now. It's fucking stupid. And I love this part. To be clear, these banks won't let you use your credit card to buy Bitcoin, but they'll happily let you use it to buy an AR-15 style semi-automatic rifle, the same kind of gun used in mass shootings. Oh my god, you do realize that more people are killed with handguns than they are with AR-15s, and that more people in America die from hammers every year than they do guns. Not to sound like a broken record, because literally every time this happens, the gun people, which includes me, come out and go, guys, we keep telling you this, more people die to hammers and fucking cars and knives than they do to guns. And inside of guns, most people die to handguns, not fucking shotguns or rifles. But they all keep shrieking about it because it's, oh my god, they killed a bunch of people. Okay, well, you can do that with a fucking bomb. That's the thing. You take away guns. I saw a beautiful fucking article years ago. It was written by an economist. He said, if you take away guns, they're just going to switch weapons. That's it. They'll just switch weapons. It's supply and demand. Their demand is that they wish to kill a bunch of people. Their supply is they just happen to grab a gun. It's convenient. You want to know what's going to happen? They'll just switch to Molotovs. They'll make pipe bombs. They'll make fucking pressure cooker bombs. They'll go running around pretending they're a goddamn ninja and use a fucking corn knife. Okay? I'll show you what a corn knife looks like. And to anybody who thinks that, you know, these aren't, oh, this is totally not a thing that people would have. No, you've clearly never been in a rural area. These are extremely common, actually. Because farmers out in the Great Plains will pay kids to go cut fucking corn. That's what this is for. It's like, oh, hey, well, what are they cutting corn for? Because the guy's got soybeans or some shit in there, and it's corn left over from last year, and he needs to get rid of it. So the kids will walk through and just hack the shit out. That's it. Okay, this is arguably worse than a gun. Do you want to know why? Guns are loud. Really fucking loud. A knife is not. Okay. No, to go, oh, we'll just ban knives. Okay, well, he'll just get a fucking screwdriver, make it more pointy, and then he'll just stab people with it. This is the point. If someone wants to fucking kill someone else, they're going to do it. Well, we should not facilitate him. Well, then he'll just fucking make it worse. Okay? This is the thing. Remember fertilizer bombs? Do you remember those? Remember fertilizer bombs? If you take away easy access to guns, which, quite frankly, leave a paper trail if you would bother to fucking follow them. Seriously. Half of these people are suspects in something or another or on some flavor of watch list. But yet nothing happens. As fucking Stick said in a recent video, most of these people are on antipsychotics. But apparently it's a fucking conspiracy theory to point that shit out. Well, I don't know. It says right there, on half of these antipsychotics, you might lapse into a psychotic rage. Holy shit, I wonder why. And then it gets worse, because now people are going, well, if you have mental problems, you can't have a gun. Okay, you want to know what you're doing now? People who have entirely manageable mental issues, like mild depression perhaps, won't go see help because they're afraid they're going to lose their gun rights. Okay? I'm not saying we should let loopy, insane people who are clear psychopaths have guns. No, that's pretty easy. But that's why people fight against that kind of distinction, because where do you draw the line? That is the problem. Do we just say violently insane people? Okay, well, what happens if the violently insane people get cured after a decade of intense therapy? Can they have a gun now? If they can't have a gun, why not? They're cured. They're sane. They're functional people now. This is the entire problem. And they just, the opponents just shriek about it. You can't fucking have it. You can't have this conversation. I'd love to have this conversation. I don't have a problem with entirely reasonable gun control. If you wanted to say, okay, everyone who wants to own a gun has to go to a hunter safety or a gun safety course. Fine, I did it when I was fucking 10. Whoopty shit. No big issue to me. I think it's a good thing. Teaches you where to point the gun barrel. Teaches you to keep your finger out of the trigger until you're ready to shoot. Teaches you to store the gun with the chamber open and the safety on and the gun unloaded. Duh. Preferably the clip out of said gun. It's very simple. That's all it is. It's usually one day. It's like 3 hours tops. Fine. I don't have a problem with that. But this just gets so stupid. It just keeps getting, and he just keeps going. It's so fucking dumb. It's like, oh, maybe we should push other people. Like, this is one right here. If Visa and MasterCard are unwilling to act on this issue, the credit card processors and banks that issue credit cards could try. Jamie Dimon, chief executive, JP Morgan Chase. Fuck you. Which issues credit cards and owns a payment processor, talked about how he and his bank have a moral obligation, but also a deeply vested interest in helping solve pressing societal challenges. No, you don't. You do not have a moral obligation. You're a corporation. You don't have moral obligations. Okay? Like I said, let's be fucking honest about that. This is a PR bullshit line. He doesn't believe that any more than fucking I do. You don't have a moral obligation. Your one point of existence as a corporation is to make money. Now, I would love for you to do that in a moral and ethical fashion. And you know what? You're not doing that, so why the fuck would I trust you to do this? I don't. And if you do, I'm gonna go buy a gun with cash out of spite. I mean, I want to buy a gun. There's a couple of guns I want to buy anyway. But I'll go do it if you do this out of spite. That'll be the last push I need to go finally get the damn thing. Okay? I'll fucking do it. I'll make a nice video of me shooting targets in my fucking dad's backyard. It'll be fun. Get some bottles. I'll blow some bottles up with a new pistol or something. It'll be great. A lot of fun there. It's so fucking stupid. I don't even know why. Why would you think this is a good plan? This is disturbing. It's like it's all a pipe dream. It's like, oh, and then they're saying like, hey, some of them sound like they're kind of, like they're going to go for it. It goes, was like, at least two executives said that a reason they haven't been more outspoken yet is that they fear reprisals from the NRA and other gun supporters, not just in the form of boycotts that could affect their bottom line, but also actions that could imperil the safety of their employees. You are aware that most gun violence isn't actually coming from large gun supporters? Like, seriously. How fucking stupid are you? Most people in the NRA are very responsible gun owners. Yes, there's the occasional retarded redneck who's going to fill up a car full of gasoline and shoot it with incendiary rounds to watch it explode. And you know what? They're dumb. And most other people laugh at it, think it's fucking cool, and then go, okay, you were an idiot. That was fucking stupid. Okay, that's a here hold my beer moment. Most people are very safe with their guns. They have them in gun safes. They have them stored unloaded. They have them fucking... they have gun locks on them, okay? People are generally safe with their firearms. Okay? The fact that you think we're all a bunch of drunken dumbasses shooting our fucking... running around shooting flies off of walls with goddamn fully powered battle rifles is insulting. I'm deeply fucking insulted right now. And you want to know what? You've probably never held a gun in your goddamn life. How about you go out somewhere, go to a shooting range. Let the guy give you a basic rundown. He'll hand you a shotgun. You can stick some birdshot in it. You can shoot some targets. And you can actually understand what the fuck it is to hold on to a firearm. You can actually get it. Because you don't. You don't understand how guns work. You don't understand any of this. Do you want to know why I have a gun? I go hunting. I have a firearm to go hunting. It also happens to function as a secondary self-defense weapon. Honestly, in my life, I'm probably never going to need it. Odds of me needing to defend myself with a firearm are probably pretty damn low. And I'm happy for that. But you know what? I'm happy that I have the gun. I'm happy that if some nutcase breaks into my house, I can run, grab my gun, shove a slug in it, and I'll be okay. That's the point. You want to take my gun away from me. Or you want them to make it really hard for me to get guns or ammunition. Why? Why do you want me to feel less safe? Why do you want me to sit here and not be able to go hunting? Do you know what that's going to do to the fucking deer population? They're going to run around, overpopulate, start hitting cars and shit, and then start dying of starvation. I'm not joking, by the way. The reason we have, most states have, that have deer hunting seasons, have them, is to control the deer population because we fucked up the ecosystem by killing off all of their natural predators. So we're it. We have to step into that ecological niche. That's not an option. And I'm not even slippery sloping that shit. If you get too many deer, they will start hitting cars. And if they get onto a highway, that's a multi-car pileup. And I don't know, it sounds real stupid. But there it is. So fucking leave my guns alone. You don't have to like guns. I would like it if every person of sound mind had a gun. Honest to God. In my own personal opinion, I feel everyone should have a gun. Or at least know how one works. Because I want everyone to be safe. I want everybody to be comfortable holding on to a firearm in case, God forbid, they ever have to use the damn thing. I'd much prefer you never had to. I'd much prefer if we never needed guns. Okay? If guns were nothing more than how swords are. Interesting, quaint relics of the past. I would love it. It'd be fantastic. But they're not. They exist now to protect you. They are a tool designed for protection. And everyone goes, but they're for killing. Yeah, because the other guy's trying to kill me. That's the tool that's going to save me. That's it. It's not fucking hard. So get your greasy corporate goddamn mitts out of my fucking guns. It's just... right, and this right here. Critics of using finance industry to influence gun sales might argue that such a move would be discriminatory against gun retailers. Because it would be. You would then be saying that we, as the banks, are allowed to say that this industry is allowed to succeed and this one is not. That is what you would be saying. Don't sugarcoat it. Don't bullshit it. That's what you're saying. You are saying that these people who make firearms a legal object are not allowed to sell it. But they could still sell it for cash, you just said it. I know. You are now making it significantly more difficult on them solely because of your own goddamn prejudices. But the next line, but gun sellers are not a protected class, like age, race, gender, religion, or even political affiliation. This would be a strictly commercial decision. No, it's not. It's not a strictly commercial fucking decision. A commercial decision would be to go, you know what, it's too fuck, no, not enough people buy these guns with fucking credit cards, so we're just going to pull our machines out of these stores because it's too fucking expensive to keep the line going. That is a strictly commercial decision. It's based solely off of profit. Is it worth it? Now, this is a moral decision. This is a moral decision you are making for everyone else. You don't have that right. The banks do not have that right. The government does not have that right. Okay? It is a moral decision. You are saying that I am not allowed to purchase this legal thing. Fuck you. That is not how this works. And then here's another one. This is very one I've said several times here. Another critique says it's impossible to prevent every shooting, no matter how guns are restricted. It's very, very true. And the bank's actions would affect millions of their own law-abiding customers, effectively dictating what they can and cannot buy. Exactly. The bank has no right to dictate what I can and cannot buy. That's like saying, no, we're not going to give you a loan for a Ford, but we'll give you a loan for a Chevy for the exact same amount of money. No. They have no right. That's what this is. You're saying, I can't buy this perfectly legal assault rifle, but I can buy that shotgun. The fuck's the difference? The fuck's the difference between me buying an M14 and me buying an AR-15? They just look different. Do the same thing. Have the same function. Hell, they have damn near the same clip size. I'm pretty sure both of them have 20-round clips. Nothing new. Nothing weird. They do the same shit. But one's a scary new rifle and the other is an old rifle. Do the same fucking job, guys. It's... And then he goes on to talk about how it will push him into the dangerous, untraceable world where sales will depend on cash. And it's true. He admits it. All things considered, though, it would make it considerably harder to even find such guns. No, it doesn't. Where do you think gangsters get all their fucking guns from, you moron? They don't walk into a gun store and buy them. They get them illegally. There's a budding fucking industry in that, you dumbasses. It's fucking, it's disturbing. Just, and at the end, at the fucking end, if they don't want to back up their words with actions, the next time there's a school shooting that prompts a conversation about gun companies, it should also include the financial complex that supports them. Because we have to clutch our pearls and think of the children. Fuck you and your emotional bullshit. And notice they only say school shooting, not just shootings. Okay? You didn't even just say violence. You're such a moron. I don't even know what to fucking think anymore. You're just such an idiot. You don't understand any of this. You don't get it. Because you probably live in some fucking big-ass urban center where a cop's right next to you. Guess what, buddy? If I call a cop, he ain't showing up to my place for 15 fucking minutes. And that ain't because he's slow. That ain't because he's fucking lazy. That's because the nearest cop station is fucking 10 miles away. Okay, buddy? You wanna know what can happen to me in 15 fucking minutes? An awful lot. And I certainly hope you never have to live through it.